So Diana, what is the difference between acute pain and chronic?
Good question. So basically it comes down to timing. Acute pain is something that happens very recent and it'll last from about anywhere from about 3 to 6 months. After the 6 month point, you're really getting into chronic pain because at that moment, if you had an injury, it's healed by then for sure. The tissues in your body heal on their own. So after 6 months, more or less, it turns into chronic pain at this point where the actual injury has healed, yet you still have pain.
Okay, so this is like the theory of pain, which, or can you, yeah.
It's more like just the timing between acute and chronic is just timing.
Okay.
If it's something that happened very recent, within 3 months, let's say, it's acute. If it's something that, you know, if a patient walks in and tells me, and I ask them, how long have you had this pain? And they tell me, 2 years. At that point, it's chronic. At that point, I'm not thinking that wherever they're having pain is actually hurt, that there's actually damage there. What really happens is just the nerves becomes, at that area, become sensitized. They become extra sensitive to pain.
And tell me about the theory of pain.
Okay, yeah. So that pretty much shows how there's inputs into the brain, and then the brain processes it, the information, and then there's outputs that come out. So the key point from this graphic to take, I think, is to see how pain is actually an output of the body. It's not something that's sent to the brain from your actual body part. It's something that the brain decides, and it decides to have pain if it feels that it's threatened or if the body's in danger. For instance, if you place your hand on the stove and it's hot, it's on. So what's going into the brain at that point would be a sensory input that this is hot. The brain processes that information and decides, okay, if we leave our hand there, you're probably gonna get burned. So at that point, it sends pain, I'm sorry, to the hand so that you can move it. So at that point, the brain is using it as a protective mechanism.